guys, Mike B, aka Phony with the BFF Report. Today, I have a game called Defiance from Trion, the makers of Rift. This game launched recently and is being made alongside a show premiering on Sci-Fi on Monday, April 15th. It's a science fiction show and a science fiction MMO all tied in together. It's not like they made a show and then later on took the IP because it was popular and made a game out of it. So this is really interesting, but we need to take a look and see how the game functions without the help of the show. Let's go. So I was one of those people that came in a little bit late to the whole Borderlands thing, starting with obviously Borderlands 1, probably about a year after it came out. And one of the first things I noticed while I was playing is that, you know, there's a lot of MMO style elements in here. I had quest hubs, I had, you know, obviously the quest givers that occupy these things, I had vendors, I had sort of a crafting system, I had character progression, I had kill X of Y and FedEx quests. I mean, I've had all of these things that I'm already familiar with. And here I am playing Borderlands, which was a co-op RPG, and I just felt like this would be a great way to kind of introduce somebody to the core mechanics of an MMO. And then here comes Defiance, which admittedly has a lot of elements that feel like Borderlands. It's obviously marketed as an MMO. So where does this fit in this whole thing? Well, to me, if Borderlands is the halfway between a shooter and an MMO FPS, then I guess Defiance somehow finds space and squeezes right in between Borderlands and, again, a regular MMO FPS, like, say, PlanetSide 2. So the question is there a market here? Is there a market for people that want to play this kind of game? And this thing comes and is piggybacking off of an actual TV show. The people you're going to see in the game are going to be on the show itself, and vice versa. But besides Escape from Butcher Bay, there's not too many games that are based off of movies or shows that are very good, and we know this. And then, of course, this is coming from Trion. They make Rift. We know they make MMOs. So some of you MMO guys are going to jump in here and you're going to be like, whoa, this is not at all what I was expecting. That's because it's not really an MMO. It's more like a gigantic co-op. And I'll explain why in a second. But first, let's go and take care of character creation. Here we have two different races, humans and the Irathian. And of course, each one has a male and a female. And then in those, we have four different classes. There's no gender or race classifications or restrictions. You can just go ahead and pick whatever one you want because it doesn't matter. The only thing it does is it changes what you start out with. So the whole origin thing, the classes, all that stuff, really that's what makes you feel good about your background story. That's all you're choosing because everything else doesn't matter. You're going to get new clothes, you're going to get new hats, you're going to get a new weapon, all that within the first like 5 minutes of playing. On the next screen here, you see we have a bunch of options here to modify your character. Everything from hair to face paint to bone structure to pretty much whatever you want. Now, the layout here is a bit funky. Sometimes you may actually miss some things, especially this top bar up here that says that you can change from the face to whatever you want. I don't understand why that element isn't kind of embedded inside of this window they've created, center left, that has all of the actual changes that you're making, all the different features you're choosing. I think the layout here is actually extremely strange, but nonetheless, the character creator is good. And if you miss that thing at the top, trust me, you're gonna miss a whole lot of customization choices. Now, once you're done here, you're gonna get into the game. There's all kinds of cinematics going on both before and after the character creation is how they kind of introduce yourself into the environment here. And once you get to the ground, this is where the tutorial takes place. This is all pretty simple. We're gonna skip all of this. They teach you how to do things. It takes like 5 minutes, then you're in the real game. Now, just like you guys would expect, you have quests. You turn around, you have an exclamation point over someone's head, just like you would expect in an MMO. Okay, go talk to this person and give you something to do. Now, obviously with this being a shooter, you're gonna have lots of quests that involve you going and shooting things, but just like a standard FPS where you have different gameplay types, you know, like a defense, or you have capture the flag, or you have assault, or whatever, they incorporate those in these games. So you're gonna have all these different POIs you have to make it to, and activate them, and then defend them for a limited time, and they work it in such a way in the open world environment that it just works. And a lot of times, as you're driving to get to that quest, you're gonna end up with all these dynamic style events. And for those of you guys who've played Rift, you're gonna see straight up rifts in this game. And I'll go into them in just a second, but these kind of dynamic events that occur as you're going from point A to point B, they don't just pop up on the map. I mean, they do. They show up on the map as a, you know, kind of exclamation point or whatever. But you're gonna hear people like talk, hey, help me out. Hey, help me this and that, whatever. Or you're gonna have a roadblock that's in place set up by the enemy and you're gonna have to go through and wipe them out in order to remove the roadblock. Of course, you can go around, but you're doing all this to earn experience to kind of level up your character.
Now, you also have side missions. You have a main mission kind of quest chain that you go through, which includes lots of spoken dialogue and everything. So you're going to get kind of this single-player RPG type of experience when you do that. But then you also have these kind of these episode tie-in missions where you're going to meet up with the main characters that are going to be in the show itself. And once again, this is going to play out a lot like more of a cinematic storyline with VO and, you know, all that stuff. And then you're going to get into an instanced mission area where it's you and these two characters from the show. And these are typically pretty easy. Sometimes, you know, you get a little focus fired and you end up kind of eating it. Other times, you know, they end up kind of being the bullet sponges for you, and you let them go out there, do their thing, while you stand in the back and just kind of do all the damage. Now, they also have these GTA-style missions where you're running about and you have these racing missions you could do, which are highly addictive. You jump on your vehicle, which everybody gets a vehicle to start out with. If you pre-ordered, apparently you get like a Dodge something. Yay, a Dodge, Mopar power, baby. But everybody else ends up with an ATV, which is fine. Most of these races are done with ATV. I've not come across one that requires a vehicle like a car yet. But these things, kind of addictive, not gonna lie. But they also have defense and killing spree style, where they basically just hook you up with like some random weapon, and they just say, go, kill a bunch of things, and you do that. Again, it's very much like Grand Theft Auto in the way they've implemented these things, and it earns you ego ratings. So why wouldn't you do it? Go get some XP, you'll get some loot, and it's a leaderboard set up, so if you're number one, everyone's gonna see your name. Yay! But essentially, it's something to do out in the open world while you're just driving around. And of course, rifts. Yes, these are rifts. Seriously, let's look at this. It comes out of nowhere, it's random, it's multi-staged, you run from point to point to clear these things up, you have these kind of pseudo-boss fights that happen, and tons of people are running around shooting everything. You can use your vehicles to ram into some of them, which usually result in you exploding and getting thrown off it, so be careful there. But it is a massive event, and it is seemingly random, just like rifts are. And while I keep referring to that, I don't mean this negatively. It's a perfect fit for this game, and it's something that we know Tryon is good at. They created this rift system, and a total works, why not put it into this game just to add more diversity? Now, when I initially got into the game, I looked at the animations, the way I was running and the way I was jumping. It seemed very, very stiff. And I realized that from an outsider perspective, you may think, well, the combat probably plays just like that. It doesn't. The combat does actually feel really good. It's solid. Some of the guns kind of lack oomph, like a shotgun, and it felt like I was shooting pellets, but the feel of combat itself is still really good. However, there are a couple issues here. While it may feel great, some of the mechanics are kind of silly. First, you have the ability to carry two weapons at once, and you can swap them out pretty much whenever you want. But you also have different loadouts that you can swap out while you're playing. As a matter of fact, the game will let you go through your inventory right in the middle of a fight and pick something else out if you want to go through and change from maybe a shotgun to a sniper rifle. It doesn't care. But then to add another layer, to, I guess, to make it easier, they have this loadout system. So you can open up your character sheet, then go and select the loadout too, and then you go back out, then you're back in the fight with... You can have a new weapon, a new perk set, a type of grenade, a new shield, a new hat. Apparently, right in the middle of this fight, you're just like, oh, Superman, change of clothes, and now you're back in the fight with a completely different person. The other major issue is the AI. It's just, as I'm progressing, I'm thinking that maybe it's going to get smarter. It's not. You could be 8 hours into the game, and they will still stand there like idiots. Their AI does not scale. They'll stand out in the middle of the open while you're shooting them. What are they thinking? They do, however, sometimes try to flush you out of cover, which is a good thing. I mean, sometimes I'm sitting there, and if they've exhausted their grenade supply, I will just sit there, and I could go make a sandwich or go do whatever, because they'll just stand there and stare at you. They won't do anything. But other times, there will be a grenade that will fall in my lap, and that's okay, good. I'm being flushed out of cover. It's about time. But it doesn't seem to compensate for the type of powers that the game gives you. Because at the beginning of the game, you have the option of choosing kind of a starting point on this perk list here. So this perk list is kind of like your skill tree layout. And you could build out from the center, the main areas here. You have clone, you have a way of amping your power outputs, you have a cloaking device, which is the one I chose. And you unlock these things as you level up. They're called ego units. But one thing the game forgets to tell you is to actually equip them. So do yourself a favor. Once you unlock something, make sure to go and equip it, because you're gonna find out that you're gonna go and unlock like six different things, but you can only equip one of them. So keep all that in mind. And I actually feel like cloak is kind of broken, kind of, okay? Because you don't have any finishing moves. So if I cloak and I sneak up behind somebody and I punch them in the back of the head, they're not going to just die. You can, however, spec to have more damage being done while you're coming out of cloak for a limited time. You could do all that stuff in the tree here, in this grid. But whenever you're faced with, you know, disabling turrets, when all the generators are behind the turrets, right? You just stealth past the turrets, go ahead and just disable the generator. Nobody notices that a generator stops running. Nobody does. Okay, wait here for a little bit. Go ahead and re-stealth. Run over to the other generator. Do the exact same thing. Once again, two generators out of three have been shut down. Nobody hears a thing. Nobody notices. So then you move on to the third one and you do the same thing. And this is the problem with the game, is that it doesn't seem to be aware of its surroundings at all. It doesn't know when it's being shot at out in the open. It doesn't know when generators are being shut down. It just doesn't see these things and react. So the AI is definitely subpar. But despite all this, they did find a way to add a bit of variety into the game by just having this massive, massive gun orgy. You have so many different types of guns in this game. Some of the ones that I've only come across a handful myself. I tend to stick with like the shotgun, the assault rifle, and whatever. I do have what's called the Diablo, and whenever I shoot somebody with it, it sets them on fire. So that's kind of nice. At least I know I'm hitting somebody, right? the damage number is not enough. But I've seen things like you shoot a rocket in the air, and then it will split off into a bunch of little rockets. I've seen weapons that will actually heal or restore shields on other players. So there's all kinds of things in the game you're going to be running across just nonstop, and you have to choose. You could choose to vendor them when you're done, because you're not gonna keep all of them, right? You're gonna vendor some, you're gonna break some down into this kind of green jello shot style currency that allows you to actually add mod slots to other weapons that maybe previously do not have mod slots, because you can pick up mods like, you know, better scope or better damage or stats or whatever, using this kind of a pseudo crafting system. And if I may recommend, don't vendor anything, especially in the under 100. Okay, if you're under ego rating 100, do not vendor anything. It's not worth it. You're gonna be making so much scrip, which is your primary kind of dollar currency in the game. You're gonna be making so much of that, there's zero reason to vendor a weapon at all in the early game. Now, I did have an opportunity to go through and try PvP for a bit. And one thing that I actually liked the most about PvP was the fact that I could actually level by doing PvP. And it was kind of fun. Cloaking is a bit broken. people that are running around with other abilities, that's great for them, but cloaking can definitely be a bit broken. Obviously, the balancing factor is that it takes upwards of a minute to actually reset. You can't just sit there and cloak every 5 seconds when you get out of combat like every other game. But overall, PvP was pretty fun. They have varying map types. They have the team deathmatch where you're inside of buildings running around. They have these open world where you're gonna be using your vehicles to do domination style matches. So they have done a pretty decent job of including a system that allows people to, again, just kind of add to the different ways that you can level up by allowing you to go in PvP, earn some ego rating, and then get out and go do like a racing mission or something. Now, so far, the biggest MMO feel that we've gotten from this is the Arc Falls, the Rift style missions out in the open. That's the probably the most amount of MMO-ness that I've gotten out of this. There's very little socialization at all. There's a chat menu, which I've not seen a single person say anything in. They do, however, make it so that your microphone is always on. So every time you log into the game, you're gonna have to go through and mute yourself. Even if you turn off incoming voice. I've done so many missions where I'm sitting there on Skype with somebody else, and apparently I forgot that my in-game mic was on the entire time. I don't know if the other guys had their incoming turned off, and if not, then they're listening to me talk about, I don't know, masturbation or something. I have no idea what I was talking to Squishy about. Probably masturbation, sure. It's funnier. And the other thing is that it would forget what my settings were, and it, even though in some cases it would reflect that it's disabled, like for example, voice. You can hear this guy is talking, right? Look at the menu, what's it say? It says off. I had to click off again, and then it disappears. Now he's done talking. Is that not annoying? I have to do that all the time. Also on the graphics side, it keeps on turning on motion blur. I don't want motion blur. Nobody likes motion blur. So I have to turn it off every time I launch the game. My keybinds, I've given up on keybinds. The reason why I don't roll in half this video, which you have a rolling mechanic, is because it's like, I don't even know what it is, an alt or something? That's not where I want roll to be. It forgets my keybinds on the keyboard, yet it remembers what my mouse does. So I have melee bound to mouse button 4 or something. It remembers that, no problem. But forget it if you want to rebind your keyboard. I don't know what the reasoning is there. I don't know why. Apparently other people are experiencing the same issue, but my God, is that annoying. So once again, who are they targeting with this? Obviously, they're going to go for the largest demographic, the people that are gonna be watching their show and they'll be playing games. This is why the game was released on consoles as well as PC. It's probably why there's not a very prominent chat box somewhere. It's because people playing consoles don't use text chat. But the problem here is that the game's success is gonna hinge on the show's success. If the show tanks completely, the game is done. Just forget it, it's done. And the reason why is simple. The game is, it's good. It's not that good, though. Nothing here really kind of stood out to me and made me feel, oh man, I need to go back and keep playing. Yes, the Gun Orgy is great. I love getting new items all the time. I love breaking them down, adding mods, this and that, whatever. I like the little bit of progression, but it wasn't enough to really pull me away from other games I'm already playing. And that's the problem with this game, is that I don't think it really offers enough to any one single group of people that's gonna be large enough to keep it going without the help of the show. But the premiere airs on April 15th. I'll be right there with you guys watching it. So you follow me on Twitter, twitter.com/akmikeb. I'll be tweeting my thoughts on it. And I really, really, really hope that they nail this thing, because again, it's probably the only way that the game is going to survive. And it's new grounds. I mean, who's doing this? Everybody does the let's make a movie and then let's make a game spinoff from it. This is something that's totally different. They're merging these two and they're running them in line with each other. Sure, your character's not gonna have like a major impact on the show itself or the writing or anything. But for me, it's kind of like Enter the Matrix when that came out. I was into the Matrix movies and I wanted to find out what was happening in between the different movies or in the background, and Enter the Matrix really did a good job of providing this parallel storyline that you could follow. And I really enjoyed that. So again, it was because I loved the show, which is why I keep saying this game needs the show to be good, because the game itself is not exactly exceptional. All right, guys, so that's pretty much it. Let me know what you guys think after you watch the show and before. I'm kind of curious what you guys think of the game as a standalone, as well as what you guys think of the show afterwards in the comments below or on Facebook, Twitter, /AKMikeB, on all of those things. My name is Mike B, aka Phony. This is BFF Reports. I'll see you guys next week. Enjoy your weekend.